Good morning, Bitcoins, and welcome to Mad Bitcoins Live. How to print paper wallets, even on an old PC that you barely use anymore. It's really only a print server. We're going to start out with step one. Step one, search Google for Tails, space, download. Download the Tails Linux ISO. As you can see here, I've already downloaded the ISO to the desktop. Now I'm going to use Nero Burning ROM to burn the ISO. Just open up Nero, select ISO, select Open, and select the Tails ISO. This will burn Tails Linux to a blank DVD. Here's a labeled copy of Tails. Incidentally, I'm using the same copy of Tails that I used on the Mac. That's right, you can use Tails on Mac or PC. Once you've burned Tails, go ahead and insert it in the DVD drive and reboot your computer. There is one more step, so I'm not going to insert it all the way yet. When you restart your computer, get ready, because you're going to have to push delete, F2, F12, or F10. As soon as your computer reboots and shows that black screen, that's when you need to push F2, F10, delete, whatever it is, to get into your BIOS. If you don't get it the first time, you might have to wait till the second time. Also, depending on the way your computer's set up, this may not be necessary. Here's the BIOS screen, and F12, F2, F2, enter setup, F12 for the boot menu. It may be different on your computer. Once you're in the BIOS menu, it's going to be different on every different kind of PC. What you need to make sure is that this one right here, the onboard or USB CD-ROM drive, is above this one right here, SATA 0, which is the hard drive. That's a little hard to understand, but basically you need to make sure that your computer boots to the CD-ROM drive before it boots to the hard drive, so that we can successfully boot to Tails Linux. Once that's set up, push Enter to save changes, usually push Escape to enter Setup, go to Exit, and go ahead and insert your Tails Linux disk. This should cause the computer to boot to the CD-ROM drive instead of to the hard drive. Here's the Tails boot screen. You just click Live, push Enter. All right, booting into Tails Linux as per usual. We don't need more options, so we're just going to click Login for now. And here we are, back in good old Tails Linux. Just like last time, I imagine the first thing we're going to have to do is install the printer driver. Welcome home, Tails. So I went ahead and powered up the printer. I've got it plugged in the back. And I'm going to go into administration, because you wouldn't want printing under preferences. You'd want it in a separate place. That's kind of confusing. Here's printing. You could push the add button, but that does nothing. So you're going to push the arrow, go to printer, and we're going to wait. As I've said before in my other video, a lot of installing Linux, a lot of installing paper wallets is about waiting. As you can see, I waited, and the HP DeskJet 1510 came right up. It's now searching for drivers, which fortunately last time were already included on the Tails Linux disk. Just forward a few times and apply to install the printer drivers. I'm pretty sure it works now. I don't feel like putting a test page out there. And then now, all you have to do is insert your USB key fob. Could be any kind of USB key fob. I got these for $6 at Fry's. All right, PC people, I'm not connected to the internet, but if I was connected to the internet, what I would do is I would open the web browser. I would go to BitAddress, two D's, two S's. Make sure you spelled it right, bitaddress.org. I would scroll down to the GitHub repository in the lower right-hand corner. After clicking that, on the GitHub page, on the lower right-hand corner as well, I would click Download Zip. This will give me the zip file that allows me to create Bitcoins offline. Then, if I was using Tails Linux, I would reboot the computer. Rebooting Tails Linux gets rid of your previous session. If anything came down during that session, rebooting would get rid of it. Once you've rebooted and you have the BitAddress library on your USB key, simply go to Places in the top menu, your USB key name, mine's called Patriot, and then the bitaddress.org master directory. Once in the bitaddress.org master directory, open up bitaddress.org.html. As with last time, it's warning us that Tor is not ready. This is because we're not on the internet. so that's an acceptable error. Move your mouse around to create randomness. This will allow us to create the Bitcoin keys. Here's our first set of Bitcoin keys. Simply click on the Paper Wallet tab. Here are the paper wallets. Orange paper wallets mean that they're not encrypted. Blue paper wallets are encrypted. We want to create encrypted paper wallets in case someone finds them. This way, they'll still need a password to get into them. Simply click BIP38 Encrypt and then add in a passphrase like passphrase. That's a fine passphrase. Then click the Generate button to recreate the paper wallets, this time encrypted. All right, we're back. And now it's time to print some wallets, which, as you know, is just as easy as going to the print button. Waiting. Everything takes waiting these days. Checking to see if your printer's still on. Might have powered off by now. And then just simply select your printer and push print. It's always good to have a backup copy, so go ahead and print, then go to print to file, then select your USB key, and create a backup copy of your keys. Go ahead and push print when you're ready. With a backup copy of your keys on your paper and on your USB stick, you're all set. All you need to do now is send a small amount of Bitcoin to the load address here, wait about 45 minutes, and then import the spend address here into your blockchain.info account. Simply log in to blockchain.info, click on Advanced, say I understand, click Import. Then it says Import Private Key. Scan this private key with a QR code reader, sometimes built into the web browser, and input it into Import the Private Key. Input your passphrase, hopefully a passphrase better than the passphrase, and your Bitcoin address here and any money in it will be linked to your blockchain account. Any additional funds sent to this linked paper address will appear in your blockchain account. But by testing the first address that you print out, you've confirmed that your passphrase works and that the other two paper wallets on the page are ready to go. Also remember that if you backed up your paper wallets to the USB key, essentially you've created one paper wallet, because if someone finds the USB key, they'd have them all. That's why a good passphrase is important. A passphrase is another level of security. If you really need to know how to test your wallets, I demonstrated in the Mac version of this video. I was able to connect to the internet then because I had Wi-Fi. This is more of an older PC that doesn't have Wi-Fi built in. It's kind of unique in that way. It's kind of secure. Until next time, make more paper wallets. Thank you.